let's start on this. I already picked a magazine page that I am in love with, and I love this woman, looks fierce. She's embodying empowerment and confidence, and I definitely want to use her as my focal point today. And then along with the colors you guys have been seeing me use lately, I'm not over those yet, so I'm going to be playing with those again, and I thought the wood would be really pretty as collage background. And then I chose some other collage elements from my buckets of goodness over here. This is a spine from a vintage book I thought would be beautiful and add some texture, and this will be up more towards the top layers, so we won't use that just yet. And then just that blushy peach that I like, and I like these words I just kind of threw out, so we'll see if we use those. And then a few collage pieces. This is real textured and gray, and I just thought that was cool. We can throw on there. And this was a vintage book page that I had used to draw up some ink blots from another art journal page, so we can rip this up, and that'll give us some great contrast with that dark against the vintage page. And we're gonna start with there. I've got my collage pieces over here if I need some more, and I'll draw some more out of here. And then my colors we've got going on today. I've got the yellow ochre, and I've got the Titan Mars Pale, and we've got the most opaque that I have found that you can use is the Heavy Body Titanium White, and I have that in Liquitex today. Of course, we have Burnt Umber, and you're gonna see me mixing various shades of this because I love Burnt Umber, and I like creating three or four different levels of darkness and lightness with the Burnt Umber. And then the light orange is over here, and I have a Naphthol Red Light in a fluid acrylic. So I'm not gonna add that to my palette just yet. I will drip it in as I need when I start mixing colors. So I have some other pastels. There's that color you'll see me make some various shades close to this hue with mixing my colors over here to the left. And so I've just got some oil pastels, some chalk pastels, some charcoal, and yeah, I think that's it in there. Here I'm about to add some collage elements, and I'm just showing the two different ways that I like to use glue to lay down my collage, one of them being matte medium and one of them being PVA glue. I chose matte medium here just because I had some pieces like the vintage book spine and some other things that are going to be coming up soon that were a little thicker. I also picked it because I already had some paint laid down on the journal pages, so they weren't exactly smooth, fresh, new journal pages. I think the PVA glue would have been fine, but I went ahead and just went with the matte medium. It's a little bit, to me, a little bit of a stronger glue. Terrifying territories. Okay, so I feel like making some marks right now because this still looks really busy, and that's fine because I know I'm gonna edit to a little later, which means I'm gonna knock back some areas and lighten some areas up and try to draw the attention to the focal point. So that means maybe not adding stark white, a lot of white, but maybe mixed and tinted white with one of these colors, but they'll be a lot lighter. That's gonna cover up some of these and where you can just see, you know, just the texture peek through and colors peek through, but we will definitely mute the busyness down a bit. But while it's still busy and it's still fun, I'm gonna make some more marks and go a little crazy and just have fun. I'm listening to jazz. This is my favorite part. And I'm getting out my oil pastels. Now, typically you would wanna use these as the last layer because you cannot put more paint or draw on top of these. These are definitely a last layer tool, unless you have clear gesso, which remember, I think we talked about one of my 5 and 5s. Gesso is a primer. It locks things in, like any water soluble things that you wanna use, like I was talking about charcoal. So I have a clear gesso that after I make all my marks, I'm gonna use charcoal. I'm gonna use oil pastels. Oil pastel is gonna be hard to put things over. Charcoal is gonna be activated by anything wet that I put on it. So I'm gonna have fun. I'm gonna put water on my charcoal. I may put a little white gesso, but when I'm done making all my fun marks and just going fun, maybe journaling, then I'm going to make sure it's all dry, and then I'm gonna cover this whole thing with a layer of clear gesso. It's gonna lock everything in and protect it all, and then we can come in with our last layer and put some focal points in, our sentiments, our words, and then we can start knocking back some of those areas and making it not so busy with some more white paint. Thing I want to point out here, just as a good reminder of some of the previous 5 and 5s that we've talked about, for the most part, all through here, I've picked analogous colors. I have picked harmonious colors that are next to each other on the color wheel. That means I can mix them, I can layer them while they're wet on there. They're gonna be beautiful and they're gonna mix and make other little hues and shades and different colors and things like that. What is gonna be my contrasting for right now, I'm gonna come in with a little bit more contrasting, but I chose a few greens in here. So when you kind of, you know, look over all that, doesn't that green pop? Well, that green is the opposite, on the opposite side of the color wheel of red. So that's my complementary color. So there's some contrast I already have going on here. Can't take it. Now I've got to thoroughly let this gesso dry. Yep, it looks a little milky and foggy right now, but it'll dry completely clear. Now that the clear gesso is dry, I am going to go ahead and start knocking back areas, making it not so busy and so loud. I'm going to use either titanium white or gesso, I'm not sure quite yet, and tint it a little bit where it's not bright white, but maybe, you know, tint it a little bit with maybe some yellow ochre or some Titan Marspel where it kind of flows a little bit better with the colors that I have on here. And then I'm going to be adding my focal point and some other words and sentiments and finish this bad boy out. Let's go. My background is a little bit busy. I went ahead and outlined the focal point with a charcoal pencil and bled it out a little bit with water. I also went ahead and added my sentiment that I wanted to over here to my second focal point, and I feel like it's very well balanced. And it says, there are far, far better things ahead than any we leave behind, C.S. Lewis. So I like that sentiment as well, because I feel like she's definitely looking into a better future. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Talk to you soon. Thanks. Bye.